The Axonius dashboard presents immediate insights based on the existing saved queries within the platform. The dashboard provides a single, consolidated, and central area to monitor and review the insights collected from adapters about all of the assets within your environment. When logging into Axonius, the dashboard page opens by default. The dashboard consists of a search bar and dashboard spaces. The dashboard spaces include charts from your saved queries from the devices and users page. Each chart refers to a visual or graphical representation of the insights that were collected from adapters. If adapters aren't configured or no data is yet to be collected, the dashboard will be empty, waiting for the initial data to be collected and represented here on this page. Let's begin with dashboard spaces. By default, Axonius includes My Dashboard and Axonius Dashboard. The Axonius dashboard is displayed by default. Within the Axonius dashboard space, default charts will be displayed. A few here are device discovery, user discovery, and adapter connection status. Within my environment, we can see the total number of assets that each adapter collected when it comes to devices and users. Between all of my configured adapters, there were 233,111 devices seen. After normalization and deduplication, there is a total of 40,363 unique devices. The adapter connection status chart is also extremely helpful for quickly observing whether or not an adapter has an active and successful connection right from the dashboard page. The second default dashboard space, My Dashboard, is only visible to your user. And as charts are added to this dashboard space, only you'll be able to see them and interact with the charts created here. When creating a new dashboard space, all that's required is the name for the dashboard space. Depending on if you're an administrator or your user's role, you can restrict space access to a new dashboard space by specifying which roles can view or edit this dashboard. Let's start by going to the space named My Dashboard and creating a new chart. When creating a new chart, we need to specify a name or a title for the chart and also select the metric. Let's begin with the metric Query Intersection. This type of chart consists of a base query and can have up to two intersecting queries. You can use this type of chart to visualize and represent the differences between two queries. After selecting the metric, the next step is to specify the module for the chart. Our two options here are users or devices. Let's select devices. From the chart wizard, we can select an existing saved query or create a new query. If you have not created a query yet for identifying all devices within your environment, I'd recommend doing so now and saving the query. Our intersecting query for this chart is going to be devices seen in the last 7 days. Again, we'll need to use a saved query that already exists within the system or create a new saved query from the chart wizard. Once we enter a base query and intersecting query, we'll see a pie graph be displayed. The green portion of the pie graph represents the total number of assets returned from the intersecting query. The gray portion of the pie graph represents the difference of number of assets returned when comparing the base query and the intersecting query. Now let's hit save on this chart. We're going to add a few more charts. Let's click on the Add New Chart icon. Our next chart metric is going to be Query Comparison. This chart shows a comparison of the number of assets returned by multiple queries. If you like, you can also change the representation of the chart from a bar graph to a pie graph. The next step is to select the queries that we'd like to compare. The two queries that I'm going to select are saved queries. The first query returns the total number of Windows devices. The second query returns the total number of devices that are not following our Windows device policy. You can add additional queries for comparison by clicking on the plus icon. Now that we have the comparison between the total number of Windows devices and devices not following our Windows device policy, let's hit save. Let's add another chart. This time we're going to use our field segmentation metric. This chart takes in a single query and will represent the bar or pie graph by the field that we select. If we choose to segment by OS type, then the bar graph will show all of the different OSs that have been seen, along with the percentages of each OS. If there is a specific value or set of values that you'd like to exclude and filter from your results, you can choose to exclude by adapter or filter by a field value. With the field segmentation chart, we can also choose to show results for devices seen in the last 7 days or a custom date range. The last step is to hit save. Let's add another chart. This time the chart metric that we're going to use is query timeline. This chart type can take up to 6 queries for comparison and displays the number of results as a trend line over the selected date range. For our example, we're going to do a comparison on the total number of Windows devices, Android devices, AWS devices, and all devices. And we're going to show the results by selecting a custom date range. Let's also save this chart. The last example of a chart that we're going to view is matrix data. Let's begin by clicking on the Add New Chart icon. For this chart, we're going to represent the return data as a table. Our base query and intersecting query are going to be devices seen in the last 7 days. The field that we're going to select for rows is OS type, and the column that we're going to select for our intersecting query is vulnerable software CVE ID. With this combination, we'll be able to see the CVE IDs associated with the operating systems that contain each CVE. This chart also gives you the ability to add the total rows, add the total columns, and to show results with no intersecting values. By selecting that detail, we'll see the operating system types that do not contain CVE IDs for the associated CVE IDs within the matrix data. Let's also be sure to hit save on this chart. When viewing dashboard charts, you can click on the icon at the top right to edit, delete, export the data as a CSV, make a copy, or refresh the data within the chart by clicking on any of these options. Some chart metrics like query intersection allow you to filter based off of historical dates. There's also an icon at the bottom left of charts represented as a pie graph to display the legend. Charts can be moved around within the dashboard space by dragging and dropping them into the order that you'd like. One final component of dashboards that we have not touched on is the search bar at the top. By typing in text into this search bar, Axonius will navigate you to any assets that match your search term. More specifically, Axonius is searching between devices and users. Within the devices page, Axonius is searching between asset names, host, serial numbers, MAC address, IP address, and last used users and tags. Within the users page, Axonius is searching between mail, username, first name, last name, and tags. If you'd like to easily make a shortcut for searching assets within Axonius in your Chrome browser, be sure to check out our documentation and search for Google Chrome.